Hello everyone, welcome to another video. Today I'd like to show you this Windows 95 looking piece of amazing software called PaulStretch. If you've never heard of this software before, well, just sit back, relax and enjoy the ride because you're definitely going to be blown away. But anyways, let's get into it. What I'm going to do is just come here to File, Open Audio File, and yes, it's a very old school menu. Just come into my desktop. And I'm going to choose the rubber chicken for now. Now, this rubber chicken is not really a rubber chicken. It's a totally different toy, but it sounds like a rubber chicken. So just have a listen. Right? So by default, whenever you load a sound to PaulStretch, it's going to stretch the file at 8 times. And right here under mode, you can select the stretch to, say, hyperstretch. And hyperstretch allows you to stretch the file up to 31 billion years. That is a lot of time. That is, I don't know what to do in 31 billion years because I can't live 31 billion. Anyways, going back to stretch, let's say that I want to stretch 200 times. And right here, you can select the stretch type. Now, being very honest with you, I don't know what is the difference between all of these types. But if you do, please let us know down in the comments because it really helps. And along with these stretch types, I also don't really understand what is going on both scientifically and technically inside the software as far as the stretch multiplier, the arbitrary filter, and binaural beats are concerned. But anyways, let's just have a listen. So that's what it sounds like 200 times stretched. So whenever I enable the stretch multiplier and say draw something like this, the effect that I have, at least my impression of it, is that this line is somehow multiplying the intensity of the sound to your left and right speakers according to the drawing of this line. So for example, this would be left speaker, this would be right speaker, right? So let's just have a listen and see what happens. Right, so what happened there was that it started quite faint and then went all the way up to the left channel and then abruptly to the right and then again to the left and then abruptly to the right again. So that's what the stretch multiplier does, its effect. But again, I don't know what is it doing to the sounds, scientifically speaking, right? I'm just going to disable this. Now, when you come here to process, you have all of these effects that you can apply. If you choose harmonics, you can select the amount of harmonics you want to hear. So if you go all the way up to 1, you're only going to listen to the fundamental frequency. And there is a pretty cool effect that it does when you ramp up the number of harmonics. So have a listen. I'm just going to also just enable the compressor just so we can listen to it louder. So that's one harmonic. Right? Pretty cool. You can also change the pitch shift and frequency shift. This one is my favorite, the octave mixer. 0 is the original dry signal. -2 is 2 octaves below. This one is the 3rd harmonic. And this one is 2 octaves above. So let's just hit play and see what happens.
Thank you.
Right. And what spread does, it spreads the bandwidth of each harmonic, but it also increases the noise. So for example, if I hit play, right, so it increases noise and distortion. And speaking of noise, you can also select between the tonal and noise informations. So right now it's just the tonal. Right? And this filter, whenever you enable it, and say draw something like this. And so what this filter is doing, whenever this dot right here is all the way down, it filters the sound very dramatically. And when it's all the way up, it doesn't. Right? So, oh, and this little slider right here is the smooth function, which allows you to smooth the curvature of the line as well. So for example, right? So I'm just going to clear that. Now, Binaural Beats is really cool because it gives movement to the sound. So this slider right here defines the intensity. So I'm just going to hit play. If I go symmetric, now, what's really cool is if I come here and choose tonal, go back to Binaural Beats. Anyways, that's pretty much it. It's really, really cool, isn't it? And remember, this is only a 48 kilohertz file. It doesn't give you any artifacts. That is really impressive. But yeah, that's pretty much it. PaulStretch is available for both Windows and Mac for free. And whenever you're done, you just come here to write to file. You can select the position that you want to render, or just select all, render selection. Just gonna save it to my desktop, rubber stretch. And there it is. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Hopefully this video was fun to you. As always, I wish you have a great day and I'll talk to you soon. See ya.